Why, good evening, everyone. That's right, we've gone razzmatazz. CBS, I said to CBS, I want things to be a bit more show business. Voila. So, what do you think of my new look, Jeff?
Don't care for it, don't care.
What do you mean you don't care for it? It's great, look, the horse looks... What did you... Oh, yeah, Mardi Gras. Right, the horse, I look great.
I got my beads. Why can't you wear beads like both of us? Why do you wear the hat and the cane? What's the deal, man?
Because I'm the chief.
The chief of what?
The chief of us.
You're the chief of us?
Yeah, I'm the chief of us. I'm the one that wears the hat and says, someone in this room is a murderer. And gosh gee willikers, I think it's you. I just hit you in the ass with a cane.
I felt it.
I'll do it again.
Do it again, please.
What? Someone in this room is a murderer, and gosh gee willikers, I think it's you.
Thank you, Daddy. May I have another?
Well, I think it's a good look. I'm going to be wearing this a lot, and possibly a pencil-thin mustache. Not here.
No.
Further south.
Further south, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Brazil.
Well, I got it. I got what you were saying. Yeah, I understand.
You're the only one. Truth is, I'm wearing the hat because everyone's a little worried about the studio audience. We had to bring out the big guns. Hat, cane, and what else?
Horse beads.
Look, you might want to stay around. It's going to be a battle of wits between me and the studio audience. But sooner or later, it's going to be all right.
With Craig Ferguson, sponsored by the makers of Zyrtec. Zyrtec, love the air. Ladies and gentlemen, Craig Ferguson.
That was one of the most believable studio reactions I've ever heard. Wasn't that great?
That was great.
Everyone backstage is worried about the studio audience.
Oh, they're really concerned? Yeah, that's
right. Yeah, yeah. We went, oh, we're really worried about this audience. I'm like, I don't give a... That's right. You don't scare me. I don't know what they're worried about anyway. I don't know what you're worried about. Like, if I was worried about audiences, I wouldn't be on this show. It's all right.
No.
It's all right. Whoa. No, I like the guy in the front row with his arms crossed. That body language, make me laugh, foreigner. Make me laugh. Dance for me, monkey. Dance. And that's when I heard about it, and I thought, well, I'll wear my hat. Thanks, everybody. Why, you know you love it. Do you want to wear this? You can wear this for a minute.
Yeah.
Nice. Lizzie, bon ton brûlé, or whatever it is. Oh, it's a great day for America, everybody! Oh, but another tense day for international diplomacy. That Ukraine thing's driving me crazy. I'm worried about it.
It's very frightening.
Yeah, it is, isn't it?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Where's your hat?
I took it off.
Oh, okay. Some people are criticizing President Obama because he was photographed wearing jeans while he was on the phone with Vladimir Putin. I mean, I think that's taking it a bit far. A suit and a tie doesn't always mean you're going to be taken seriously. He should have probably had a hat.
Yeah.
Experts say we're hurtling toward a nightmare scenario that didn't seem possible just a few weeks ago. A world brought to the brink of war by an insane madman not from North Korea. Yeah, I don't think that's funny either. It's like, oh, that's all right. Tonight, though, is Mardi Gras, the biggest celebration in New Orleans. New Orleans is... Well done, everybody. If you were really a party animal, though, I don't think you would be in the audience here. You'd be in New Orleans. New Orleans has many nicknames. Most people call it the Big Easy. I thought that was Khloe Kardashian.
Yeah. There you go.
Oh, now you're happy. Ah, that's it. Is that why you're wearing the... Oh, right, I get it. So do you have to show your... Okay. This past weekend, thousands of visitors descended upon New Orleans to drink themselves stupid and behave badly. So it's just like any other weekend, really, in New Orleans. Unfortunately, it was very cold out there today. People in Bourbon Street were warned to be careful and avoid getting cut by sharp nipples.
Very calm.
Mardi Gras is for Fat Tuesday. People stuff themselves right before Lent. That's when Catholics traditionally fast. Every religion has that, where people fast to prove their devotion. Catholics have Lent, and here in LA we have Oscar season. They're still going on, the Oscars, aren't they?
Yeah, they're still on.
Yeah, I stopped watching a while ago. Catholics all over the world celebrate Mardi Gras. There's a big festival in Rome. The Italians take to the streets shouting, waving their arms. Then Mardi Gras starts. It's crazy. Even the Pope gets involved. I like this Pope. He's the most interesting Pope in the world. I don't always throw beads from my balcony. But when I do, it's at Mardi Gras. Don't show me your boobies. Don't. Just take the beads. It's okay. I've noticed my Pope impersonation is turning a little bit into Dracula.
Very Dracula, yeah.
I am Dracula. Do you think Dracula would love Mardi Gras?
Oh, yeah, hell yeah.
Show me your beads. No, higher. The neck. Yes! The world's biggest Mardi Gras celebration is in Rio de Janeiro in Brazil. It's a carnival. You know, it's like Mardi Gras, except there's more Brazilians. You don't want a Brazilian in New Orleans because it's cold there right now.
That's right.
It's good to have a Brazilian when you're wearing these outfits because they, you know, they're... Anyway, look, yeah. No, just relax, everybody. It's all right. You've proved your worth to me now.
This is good.
Yeah, it is good, isn't it? Oh, man. I'm loving it. Here, let me take this. Pay attention, everyone. Psychologists say that costumes and masks are very important because people tend to get crazier when they feel anonymous. You know, but these little eye masks are so small, I think you can still tell who's under there. So, Jeff, take a look at these photos and tell me if you can guess who it is. Who is this, Jeff?
That's you. That's you. No?
No? Me?
Yeah, I thought that was you. No, it's not you?
Yes, it is.
Okay.
All right. All right, Jeff, picture number two. Take a look at this.
Okay. Is that you? Is that you?
Yeah.
No, okay. All right.
And another one?
Okay. No, I know this one. That is definitely you.
That is you. That is, in fact, me.
That is you.
Yeah. I've been to Mardi Gras, but I don't drink anymore. Well, I might start tonight. I don't drink anymore. It's not a great fit bringing me to Mardi Gras. You see why I don't drink anymore. This is me sober. I love you, man. Taking me to Mardi Gras is like taking Elton John to Hooters. Jeff, you got it. Taking me to Mardi Gras.
Yeah, no, like. That's good. That's good. There you go.
Yeah. Hey, I'm enjoying this steak. This is good. I'm gonna keep this in the hat. It's gonna be awesome.
I like that, yeah.
All right. Taking me to Mardi Gras is like Elton John to Hooters. What have you got?
It's like bringing Marilyn Manson to a tanning salon.
Not bad. Yeah. Taking me to Mardi Gras is like taking Mel Gibson to a bar mitzvah.
That's good. Yep. Yeah. There you go.
No. Well, he's gonna do one now.
Oh, it's like bringing Taylor Swift to a wedding planner.
Okay. Like bringing Honey Boo Boo to a shoe store.
There you go. Yep. Oh, like bringing a supermodel to an all-you-can-eat buffet.
Like bringing Vladimir Putin to a pro-Ukraine rally.
You win. That's the one. You win.
Is that it?
That's
it. Done?
That's the one.
All right, we're done then. I like this. Look at that. Look. Whoa. I wish CBS was in 3D. You know why they can't have CBS in 3D? You know why? Legally, 60 minutes. It would freak the out of everybody. Think it through. You want to see the cast of 60 Minutes?
Fine.
Like, maybe Anderson Cooper. Maybe.
Maybe. I've seen him in 3D up close, so that's fine.
We'll be right back after these messages, everybody. And sit a spell, why don't you? Ah!
I like that mustache. Look at
that. Yeah, you did? Yeah, look. Would classic. You like a mustache? Stay right there, my friend.
All right.
A bit of music for me crossing over, Alfredo.
All right, here we go.
There you are. Why, Jeff, you look spectacular.
This makes me want to speak differently.
Are you going to speak like this?
I am. I feel really proper tonight, as a matter of fact.
Well, if you're going to speak like that, I'm going to speak like a slightly drunk Englishman.
Well, I think I'll do the same. I'll do the same.
Well, it'll be an interesting show.
You're funny, man. You're funny.
You're not English, are you?
I don't even know who I am anymore.
What about you? Are you slightly drunk? Seems to me... Wait, quietly. Seems to me... You know what? I can feel the audience go, if we applaud, they might stop.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah. If we applaud, they'll move on to a different bit. Sadly, you're mistaken. I will not be bullied by the studio audience, will you, Jeff?
No, I won't, Chief.
Absolutely not. What about you, my lovely friend, BD? There you are. What time is it, Jeffrey Peterson?
It's tweet mail time. Time to take advice from a man who once danced under the name Fat Tuesday.
That's true.
Play the jingle, would you?
And your emails. Ooh.
And your emails. Email time again. This This is from Jim in Concord, New Hampshire. Wait! We are going to Concord. I'm playing in Concord. Concord. I'm doing a show in Concord, New Hampshire.
Yeah.
Soon. Not tonight. I'm too drunk to get there tonight.
No, you can't drive anywhere tonight, but you'll be in Concord.
I will be in Concord very soon. I'm playing at the theater there. I believe it's called the... Anyway, he says, hi, Craig. We're freezing up here in New Hampshire. Can I come and stay with you and Jeff, with you or Jeff, for a while in California? Absolutely not. But you're welcome to come and buy a ticket for the show in Concord, New Hampshire. Craig, don't you mean I'll give you a free ticket? Absolutely not. Not that drunk. Not drunk at all.
No, you're fine. You're acting. You're pretending. I'm pretending.
I'm pretending right. Like some of the great pretenders that won Oscars.
Sure, the great... Oh, we call them actors, but you call them pretenders.
That's right. That's what I call them. This is from Lawrence in Everett, Massachusetts. It says, Craig, who do you and Jeff think is the sexiest man alive? Easy. Elijah Wood.
Elijah Wood. No question. Yeah. No question.
No question. Who's our first guest tonight?
Well, Elijah Wood. But
that's
still,
lucky.
That's not the point. The point is...
Yeah.
All right.
and he's come on a great night.
He's coming on the night that this is the night to be here.
This is the one.
No, we need a little meditation music.
Yeah, that'd be good. That'd be good.
No. That's not meditation music. That's sexy noir bartender music.
That's right. Yeah.
Yeah. This is meditation. Don't worry about Lisa's hurt her foot. That's why she was wearing a surgical. She's Irish and she hurt it dancing. Right?
Yeah, that's what they do. They do little dances.
Little dances. Hi, diddly dee. Where's me lucky charms? I'm drunk. Good night, Boston.
Yeah.
My first guest tonight is the sexiest man in the world. He's a terrific actor. His new film, Grand Piano, opens on Friday. Take a look at this. That's not funny at all! Elijah Wood, everybody, Elijah Wood!
There seems to be a malfunction with the hand. Jeff, is your hand...
Thank you.
What happened to your hand, Jeff?
It's okay, man. It's okay. Don't worry about it. Thank you.
I couldn't help but notice that backstage.
Yeah. No,
I just wanted to make sure he was all right.
It was during
the meditation, when y'all were meditating.
Yeah?
I just saw that you were in a meditative pose, which
is great. Right,
but
right.
The one hand was just... What's happened, Jeff?
Yeah, CBS cares.
Apparently.
Yeah.
He got a mustache.
That's true?
Yeah. I see you don't have a mustache.
I don't, no.
What's wrong?
Well, I don't grow a very good mustache.
I'm terrible at mustache. I tried growing one once.
Can you grow a beard, though?
Only about halfway down my chest. Like, the top of it comes to about here, and then the rest of it's just...
You don't get the connectors?
No, I don't get the connectors. I get very little here, actually, at all.
I get little patchy bits here and a bit here. Mustache is all right, but I don't know.
What about downstairs?
It's fantastic.
Yeah, me too. It's like
a jungle down there. It's a jungle.
It's a jungle. Sometimes it makes me wonder how I keep
from
going
under.
Exactly so.
Right. That's right.
Exactly so.
That's what that song was about.
Yeah. Hey, do you want to see a... I've just seen... Do you want to see a picture of me with my moustache?
Yeah.
Should we put the thing up? There you go. That's when I grew my moustache.
Is that... Wow.
Yeah, people went crazy.
It's not bad.
Yeah, it's pretty bad. We had to put mascara on it. This film was...
Did you do mascara?
No.
I've done that.
Have you really?
I have. I've had like a weedy little moustache, and I actually filled it in a little bit. But I didn't keep it. I didn't keep it for very long.
Because take a selfie, tweet it, and then shave it off?
Yeah, done.
That's what I did.
Maximum 2-3 days is the most
I've ever. Yeah, you can't go further than that. Unless you're, what's his name?
Burt Reynolds.
Yeah, okay, sure. That'll do. Yeah.
Sure.
So, this film looks scary.
It's like an old classic thriller. It's
like one of them old scary horror, well, not horror, but kind of.
No, like a kind of Hitchcockian. Yeah. It's like Alfred Hitchcock or Brian De Palma gets compared.
And then, you know, but you have to keep playing or you'll get shot?
Yeah, that's the conceit. The idea is that I'm a piano player, returns the instrument after 5 years of being absent because he had botched a particular performance during a concert, comes back to the instrument as he's playing, he's looking through his score to see what the next bit is during a rest, and he sees there's notes written into his score.
Like, you die soon, Pen?
And basically,
kind of
like, yeah, if you mess up, you'll be shot, you and your wife. And so the whole, about 70% of the movie is my character trying not to.
Could you play the piano?
well, not as well as it would seem.
Because you were like looking up and play. That's the hardest thing to do, look up and play.
Yeah, it is. That's really hard.
Yeah, well, don't do it again.
What's harder is playing and talking at the same time. Because
really?
In the film, yeah, I mean, obviously I can't play like that. I took lessons when I was young, when I was between 10 to 14, but then I quit, like a lot of kids do. I was
on,
like...
you discovered something more interesting than piano at about 14?
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So, you didn't so much quit the instrument as change the instrument. Is that what we're saying?
To the skin flute?
Is oh, hey! Come on, man!
Guys!
Try and keep it the tone... never mind.
So anyway, in the film, I am approximating the instrument, but there's scenes, there's particular shots where I'm listening to John Cusack's voice, having to respond to him with dialogue, and also listen to the music and be on time. It was intense.
That sounds like reading the news, man. You don't want to do that.
No.
They've got. Even when they're in the, they tried to do that when I started here. They said, "We'll give you an earpiece so we can give you instruction."
Oh no.
Yeah.
So that during the show they would direct you.
No, I never let them do it, but it was like, yeah, you know, Craig, could you ask him what it's like to work with George Clooney?
It's a terrible idea.
I know it's a terrible idea. No, actually, it's not a terrible idea. I've just heard it's not a terrible idea. No, they asked me if I wanted to do it right at the beginning.
You know, there are some actors I've heard that actually have that as a common thing and will have music playing while they're in a scene or sometimes have dialogue read to them.
How can you do your pretending if all that's going on?
I don't know. I imagine. I don't know if I could do it.
I do know one actor who two actors, but one of the actors is very famous and one of the actors is not famous at all. And the not famous actor told me this story that he was doing a scene with this very famous actor whose name I'll tell you in the commercial break. And the very famous actor was writing his lines on post-it notes and putting it on his forehead. So that when he was doing his singles, he would turn and look and go and read the line and then go back. And he was, you know who it is, right?
I've heard the story.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a great story.
Yeah, and it's true. Do we
you
know
guys don't get to hear it.
Yeah. And we can't tell you who it is. Christopher Walken. We'll be right back with Elijah Wood, everybody. Yeah. Oh, hi!
Oh, hey!
Welcome back. We were just about to make out, but we won't now, obviously. Obviously, we won't then. So we were just talking about you thinking maybe you'd want to go and swim with sharks.
I would love to do that.
Would you really?
Sure.
Yeah.
I've done it, actually.
So have I.
Have you? Where?
The Bahamas.
Same.
Stewart's Cove's diving thing?
Yeah. It's great.
It's an amazing experience.
Really?
I will never do it again. Were you frightened?
No, I loved it.
Yeah, I so did I, yeah.
It's two dives. You did the two things, right?
I did the sand dive in the circle, and yeah. the big sharks, and they're like, they're, mm. And then on the wreck.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, on a wreck.
Oh, yeah.
See, we did a seawall.
Ah, so seawall's for...
I was fucked.
No, the wreck.
It's a... Can I say that word? It's a Scottish word!
You're a racist, man.
Ooh la la! The Scottish word.
Scottish word. Yeah, see, he said it. He's a light...
Crikey.
...the word! He has to be able to say that! Dude, Lord of the Rings!
Look, does that just give me free license?
Yeah. Tootsie fruits. Do what you want.
Sure.
Yeah, you know you can.
Well...
Yeah, come on, man. You're like a nerd god now.
Maybe at Comic-Con I could do whatever.
Yeah, you could, but anybody can do anything they like at Comic-Con. That's the glory of it.
It's true.
You just don't wanna.
No.
You see everybody, you're like, put it back on, everybody.
Yeah. I've actually been to a fetish party there. There's like a strange event that happens
every year. You intrigue me.
No, there's a strange event that happens every year, and I can't remember the name of it. And I went one year, and it's sort of, I mean, it's not, you know, eyes wide shut sort of happenings, but it's like vaguely fetishistic and people in kind of bondage.
And are people getting up to nonsense around the...
No, it didn't ever go, it was sort of PG-13. You know,
well, and I'm afraid I won't be going.
It was bizarre. It was bizarre.
I'm at the Eyes Wide Shut party, sitting in a chair, naked, smoking a cigar. Young people do things for me. Ha!
Good times. Anyway, we're out of time.
Are we really?
Yeah.
I was kind of sad I didn't get to enjoy your meditation. That seemed great.
You want to meditate a little?
I'd love to meditate.
Let's do it.
I think this audience would particularly love it.
They've been doing it the whole show.
Yeah.
Premiering on Lifetime March the 8th. Please welcome the lovely Keke Palmer, everybody. Keke Palmer. How are you? You look sensational. I mean, just beautiful.
You always make me feel so good.
Well, here's the thing. I mean, you started coming on the show when you were 12 years old.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Very.
It's a very weird thing for me because I'm like, whoa. It's kind of you've changed so much.
I know. I'm glad we can have these reunions. You know. I want to show you my new tattoo.
Please.
We both got our tattoos. Well, you got some other tattoos. I got mine in New Orleans, too.
Did you go to Electric Ladyland?
No. Is that the place you got yours?
That's the only place to go in New Orleans.
I got to go check that place out.
Yeah, well, let me see
your
tattoo.
I love tattoos.
What'd you get?
God is love.
Controversial. That's a controversial one. A lot of people will be like, I don't know, Keke. I don't know. Is that your first one?
No, I actually have five. I have this one, too. Look.
Oh, look. Do you mind if I read it? I don't want to get
too...
All right. We are what we repeatedly do. Excellence, then, is not an act, but a habit. That's very good.
Aristotle.
Yeah. Aristotle?
Aristotle. I talk to him every now and then.
Aristotle? This is very impressive, having Aristotle tattooed in your armpit.
Thank you for that.
Are you a student of Aristotle?
I was for some time.
Really?
Yes, you know.
I know next to nothing about Aristotle, I suppose. Other than what I've read on your arm.
Well, I got
He was very clever.
He was very clever.
Yeah, yeah. Well, that's... where are the other ones, then?
I have one under here.
Don't bother with that.
And then I have one on my ankle.
A little anchor.
Anchor, you know. Yeah. And I got a heart, two hearts behind my ear. My sister and I got that together.
Oh, and that's that for you and your sister.
Yeah. Did what's
up, you got them in all your tattoos in places that really hurt. Are you into pain? Hold on a second. Are you into pain?
You're your therapist.
I'm doing the therapist.
You're therapist. Yeah. You know what? I will admit this. Whenever I get a tattoo, I kind of do like it.
What the
feeling? Pain.
You know, I kind of do too. Except when I got it here. That was here. Like,
oh, yeah, like that.
Right, that, no, there is okay. But just when it creeps into your.
It creeped up too high. You let it creep up too high. You let it creep up too high.
Yeah. You don't, and when you start, when you're like a middle aged white guy and you start crying in the tattoo parlor, it's the funniest thing.
They got you to the tears.
Oh, yeah, I was like.
No. You have picture tattoos. I don't really have many picture tattoos. I usually quote it up, and I had to get myself to stop because I always go to this website to get these quotes, and if I would have kept going, I really would be a quote book on my whole body. I put too many quotes on me.
Well, that's all right. That's going to make you... you're pretty interesting anyway. I mean, but, but like, you know, you people could read you.
Literally.
You could start a story, and then if you like someone, you could say, do you want to see chapter two? What's the thing on the Lifetime? What's that about?
So I did a trip to Bountiful. That'll be coming out March 8th.
Right.
Cicely Tyson, which was so awesome to get to work with her.
Yeah, she's good.
Period piece. First big period piece I've ever done. The last thing I did.
What period is it?
1950s.
Oh, right,
1953.
Okay. So you would have phones like this?
Yes. Well, how do you even use this?
I have no idea.
How do you get this stuff?
Oh! Here, Keke, you've been in the 1950s. You do it. Here.
Okay. What's going on?
Yeah, hello. How you doing?
I'm doing pretty good. How'd you know to find me?
Oh, I know where you are. I've always known. Say, let's cut right to chapter four, shall we?
Excuse me. What the hell's going on? Me, if you noticed when you were, I wasn't going talking like this. I'm not that good. That was.
I'm not that good.
I can.
I'm gonna start talking like you.
What? Can you?
Can you?
Can you say, oh, cheeky monkey, Shrek, donkey, farty, oh, donkey, yeah!
Oh. You went too fast.
Well, that's a problem I've had before. Yeah, I had po' boys in New Orleans. I had oysters. You have oysters?
I didn't have oysters yet, but I really do love oysters. You love oysters?
No.
Why?
It's like salty snot going down your... I didn't like it at all. I mean, and they were really good, and the people were really nice, and they were like... You know, that way they talk.
Oh, yeah.
They
always say baby.
Yeah, well, not to me, but they... But they gave me the thing, and I was like,
I went into it.
No, and Steve Carell was with me, and
Steve Carell?
Yeah, yeah, and I said, he said, if you eat one, I'll eat one, because he'd never had them. Then I ate one, and he said, I'm not doing it.
That's like, how my dad is.
What?
My dad never wants to try stuff. I'm like, come on, Dad. He's like, nah, Keith.
Really? Why not?
I don't know. My dad never wants to try new things.
Well, Did you take him to New Orleans? Has he got any tattoos?
I didn't take him. My dad did drop me off in New Orleans, actually. He didn't stay. He just, like, got me set up while I was there, because it was like a girl's trip.
Does he have a helicopter?
No, he just made sure, like, we had to rent a car. You know, he did the whole dad thing.
Oh, that's good.
He's pretty cool.
Yeah, that's nice.
Yeah.
I don't know if I could leave my daughter in New Orleans for the weekend, though. That'd be kind of tricky. I don't have a daughter, but if I did, like, I wouldn't leave my boys there. Actually, well, one of them's only three. It would be kind of illegal.
It would be crazy.
Crazy. Yeah. Well, we're out of time.
You always do this to me.
Well, it's, you know, it's the nature of time. It has a beginning and a middle.
After
and
all we've been through.
We haven't been through that much.
What happened to the 12 years old, to the whole big thing? This is all a joke to you?
Look, Keke, I've watched you grow into a fine young woman, but I have to tell you, it's time for you to go off now and do your own thing. You can't be hanging around here with me and Jeff and Secretariat looking after you the whole time. Why, you gotta go out there and experience your life. Get a few tattoos.
I got to get some chapter sixes, huh?
I don't think I should be reading those. Get a few more episodes. Awkward pause or meditation?
Give me it again.
Awkward pause or meditation?
Awkward pause.
You're like I'm scaring you. Am I scaring you?
No. I'm scarier than you.
Yes. They're from Glasgow in Scotland, and they're here performing All I Want Is My Baby. Please welcome Glasvegas, everybody! Glasvegas!
It's all about the money, 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 money. I hope it makes you happy. Society's is my example. I said for my daughter and my family, when all I want is my baby, all I want is my baby. Economic, social, and cultural hypocrisy, it kills me inside. Take it up there. For now, an extra kiss a day. We come from an adventure. I can see you to destiny. Little ghetto feelings, my more than biology. If I held a camera, maybe I will do one day. How delighted did you saw me in your false ideology? Now you see how, now you don't, now you see how, now you don't.